Next up today is fellow Irish woman Leah, who's no stranger to surgery, but wants help deciding if she should go back under the knife once again.
I'm Leah and I'm 30 years old. I've struggled with my weight since as long as I can remember. There was no switch off button in my brain. I literally could eat, eat, eat and never felt satisfied. I don't wanna lose. I reached 22 stone not even 12 months after my son was born. That was like breaking point. I'm getting upset now. It was hard. Something that I wanted to change but I had no control over. It was tough. I just knew I couldn't live like this anymore and got gastric bypass surgery and lost nearly 12 stone. I'm just so proud of myself that I've actually finally got somewhere I never thought I'd be, and I'm left with something that I just don't like. This problem won't be solved by healthy eating and exercise. It's going to need medical help. And I've recently had a tummy tuck with a body lift and extended arm lift. I've sorted out like the top half of me, and I'm just not 100% sure if I want to go through it again. It's going to be something I'll have to forever be hiding if I don't get the problem solved. And I feel then I'll be able to, you know, just live my best life.
Hello, Leah.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
So tell me, what is going on with your body?
So I've actually been through like a major transformation in my life. I've lost lots of weight and I've had skin removal.
How much weight have you lost?
I am down 160 pounds, so nearly 12 stone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Have you always had an issue around your body?
I've been overweight since I was like 6 years old.
Yeah.
Something had to change. And I got referred for a bariatric surgery.
What's a bariatric surgery?
So that is weight loss surgery. So my esophagus basically bypasses my stomach. So I have a pouch. And then obviously you're left with all excess skin. Mm-hmm. And I have had skin removal, which I'm, you know, very happy with my body and how I look at the moment. But there's just some...
Your body looks amazing. You look like you're a gym goer.
I actually just qualified as a PT as well.
Yes.
In August. So.
So there's just one part of your body that you're just still not happy with.
Still not happy. Like, you know, you can be dressed, you can hide things, but when I'm undressed, there's just something. And I think I deserve to live in a body that I love, you know?
I completely agree with you.
Life is for living.
It certainly is. Well, here's what we can do. We have a team of digital artists and surgeons who've created an avatar of your body, how it is now, and they've also created two surgical options so you can see what you would look like if you did decide to go down the surgery route.
Perfect.
Now, first, before we do anything else, we need to see what your issue is.
Okay.
Are you ready to see what you look
yeah.
like now? Okay, let's have a look. And there you are. Wow, you have lost a lot of weight.
Yeah. My scars now are like even a bit redder now than they actually are already.
So your scars have already gone down.
They're faded
more.
Even more now.
How do you feel about your body there?
I can see the issue that you know, it's not in proportion with what the rest of me.
I think you have a really amazing figure. Go on, what is it?
It's my legs. Obviously, you can kind of see the loose skin, but it doesn't even look that bad. If I was to go walking or running, you can see...
the loose skin,
yeah.
Okay.
My skin looks like an elderly lady's skin. It's, like, jiggly, it's, like, wrinkly. I actually can even pinch it and I can't even feel it. A stranger who has no connection with you will tell you how it is. So I'm here, I'm strangely calm. It's a bit surreal, but I just can't wait to see the outcome.
Does it affect you, like, physically when you're trying to go running? It's just like...
Well, yeah, like, you suffer very bad, like, boils and things like that.
Really?
When I had my arms, if you, like, bend over, it's, like, gather, and my legs do the exact same thing there.
Yeah. What are you hoping to see different?
I just want the excess gone.
Yeah. Are you ready to see your first option? Mm. Let's reveal your new pair of legs. What do you think?
I can see already, like...
Okay, so I get what you mean there.
Yeah.
I mean, it does look good. Is that what you were hoping for?
Yeah, and, like, my knees bother me as well, but that's why I'm like, is the other surgery now might be, like, an extended toilet. I'm not sure really what I'll need. I'm hoping for miracles, I think.
I hadn't even looked at your knees. I feel like you're being very critical. But, like, how much of a difference can you see on your thighs?
I think there's a major difference. There's no way I'd go out this summer now with a pair of shorts on.
Unless you've had the surgery.
That skin done, like, yeah.
You're quite excited by that option.
Yeah.
Will we speak to our surgeon, Sujatha?
I'd love to.
Hi, Vogue. Hi, Leah.
Hi, Sujatha. What's involved in this operation?
So this, what you're seeing here, is a standard thigh lift. The advantage is that the scar is limited just to the groin area, so it's not really that visible.
That's a bonus, because it is such a small scar.
Yeah, yeah.
So with this procedure, we take out a crescent-shaped area of skin in the groin area, and the remaining skin on the middle and lower parts of your thigh are pulled up to close the wound.
How much does it cost and what is the recovery time?
The cost for this procedure does vary depending on the surgeon you choose, the clinic or the hospital. But generally, I would say a standard thigh lift would be £7,000 upwards.
Oof, that's quite expensive. Have you got your thigh fund?
Not yet.
So about a couple of weeks for the recovery. Because of the location, it can be uncomfortable. So getting back to normal activities such as exercise, that'd be more around about 6 weeks.
Yeah, I think, like, the thighs give me a bit of, like, the fear. Because yeah. I feel like, you know, we need your legs to get up out of the bed, to go to the toilet. They need to carry everywhere.
Yeah. So, Sujatha, what about the risks on a surgery like this?
Obviously, the groin area is not the cleanest area, so there is a risk of infection. And also, because of the movement of the legs, there's a risk that the wound can separate.
Does that kind of scare you?
It does. It does. I was very lucky, obviously, with my previous surgery. My body healed fairly quickly, but there's always that what if in the back of your head. You just never know.
Thank you, Sujatha.
Thank you.
Earlier in the show, we met 30-year-old Leah, whose amazing weight loss journey has left her with excess skin on her thighs.
I'm not sure really what I need. I'm hoping for miracles, I think.
She's faced her first surgical option.
There's no way I'd go out this summer now with a pair of shorts on.
Unless you've had the surgery.
That skin done.
But there's more for Leah to see. Well, you did want to see more than one option.
Yeah.
Would you like to see your second option?
I do.
Okay, let's have a look. Wow. Now, is there a big enough difference there for you?
Yeah. I know it gives me more definition, but then I feel like the end half of my legs look a bit bigger than the top half. I always would have had, like, big calves and things anyway. I don't know, does it take...
Is that an Irish girl thing that we all have big calves?
I don't know.
I think it is.
I don't know. Why do they give us big calves?
Should we take a closer look? The scar sticks out to me there.
Yeah.
Would you feel self-conscious about that scar going down your legs?
I'm just, like, there, my journey, and... Yeah. It's just part of my journey, so the scars wouldn't bother me at all, whatsoever.
Will we find out a bit more?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, Sujatha. So what did you do here?
So this is a more complex procedure called an extended thigh lift, and we've combined it with liposuction so that we can make the thighs thinner and contour them. We put in local anaesthetic and adrenaline. That helps reduce any bleeding and bruising after the procedure. Once the liposuction has been removed, you'll have a lot more excess skin. So then we would go on to do the thigh lift. But the extended one, it allows us to remove a lot more skin, makes your thighs a lot more thinner and more contoured, but in exchange for more scarring, unfortunately.
How do you feel about liposuction?
Lipo, actually, something I don't want.
Yeah.
People say the pain after the lipo is nearly worse than the incisions themselves.
It's extra pain that you probably don't need.
Yeah.
So, Sujatha, what are the risks for this one?
You mentioned it's really uncomfortable, and that is fully true. It takes a good 3 weeks for you to sort of get back to normal. With the liposuction also, the risk of sort of contour deformities or irregularities in the skin. The skin may not be exactly smooth. As surgeons, we try not to stay too close to the skin and also do the liposuction evenly so that we minimise these problems.
How do you feel about all of that?
It's a lot to take in.
How much extra would this one cost?
For this, again, prices can vary, but I would say more around £10,000, perhaps more, depending on where you choose to have it.
Thank you, Sujatha.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye, Leah.
Bye.
When we first met Leah, she was hiding a pair of legs she wasn't happy with. Seeing a thigh lift and an extended thigh lift with liposuction gave Leah lots to think about. So, what did she decide?
Hi guys, so since the show, I've been going through my options and I decided to go with option one, and that would be the viewer's vote. So I think it matches my body perfect. I just had more surgery recently, which was a breast lift and armpit skin removal, so I'm just gonna give my body time to recover and get ready for the next journey.